Hello, this is Professor Paul Gruen from Quinnipiac University, adjunct professor to ICM 590 Project Planning. And we're here again with Lynn Van Sweden, a co-worker from Yale University. She's a senior project manager. I've worked with her now for a little over a year. And she's a certified PMI, is that the right
PMP,
term?
PMP, yes.
PMP, certified project manager. And she has project management down. She's really saved us over the one big project where I first met Lynn was our web methods upgrade. And while a bunch of us fought her tooth and nail in it, she really did help implement a good and successful project. We had our last talk was on communication, and we talked about what communication was. And now we're going to roll into the whole topic of milestones. So Lynn, let's break this off into probably two major sections. The first being, what are milestones to you and how are they used within a project? And then what isn't a milestone? What's oftentimes people might get confused and call something a milestone when it really isn't. So what really in that second question, we're really wanting to make sure that a milestone is kind of elevated to really what it is, and other things don't confuse it. So let's start off with, what's a milestone to you, and how do you use them in projects?
Good questions. I told you we talked in the last interview that I'm a pretty simple and basic person. So when I think of a milestone, I think of things in my life that I can relate it to. People see milestones every day, and I'll give you an example. When you're driving along the highway, and you see a mile marker,
right.
That's a milestone. It either tells you how many miles into a state you've gone or how many miles you have to go to be out of that state. And so when I think of a milestone in a project, it's very much the same thing. A milestone that is, once I have that, it kind of tells me how much more time I have to get to something else. I'll give you an example. If getting a charter with a vendor is vendor signed, is a milestone, and in many projects it is.
Right.
Usually, as a project manager, I know that once that vendor contract is signed, I have about, we'll say, 10 months left to deliver that project, depending on the project.
Sure.
And so that milestone, getting the contract signed, is an indicator of how much more time I have to go.
So that basically says to me that if a person has, if you set a milestone like having a vendor sign a contract, and let's assume a one-year project, and it took you 2 months to get that, then you know the rest of the project's going to take 10 months. That says to me that if something happened along the way, and let's say a project started in January, it got signed the end of February, and that means you're on schedule for delivery December 31st, but something happens now to that project, to the vendor signing milestone, and it took an additional month. Maybe it had to go through legal counsel or things like that before it could actually get signed. So now instead of hitting the vendor signing milestone in the end of February, you hit it in the end of March. Now what's happened? What's happened to the rest of your time? Because before we've said December 31st was when we were going to deliver.
Exactly. But if that milestone doesn't occur when it's been anticipated, and I know that it's going to take me another 10 months after that milestone to deliver, I know that my project is technically or potentially a month behind already. And so it's also then an indicator then of my schedule and where am I.
So that either means one of two things, obviously. Hopefully you added enough time in your time estimates to give you a little bit of flexibility, and we'll be talking about time estimates in another video. It might mean that you have to do a whole lot more work to make up that month, or you're going to be a month late. You're going to have to tell your customer and stuff, well, instead of this end of December, it's the end of January, and most likely they might not like that. Or you might actually have to drop some things out to make up that difference. So milestones, they do tell you how far you've gone, how far you've traveled. Hey, I made it this far. But they also kind of help you let you know, well, you still got this much to go to finish it.
Exactly.
And what do you think about the point of milestones? I always think of milestones as mini celebrations. And I don't like to compare them to like a task list. So how do you think about using milestones as a positive encouragement for the team?
I like to use them as a positive encouragement because it means that the team has collectively accomplished something.
Right.
And it also then lets the team know it took us this much time to accomplish this. Again, so that moment in time, we know how far we have come, and we also know how far we have to go. And so as a team, we can kind of look at that, the overall project, to the next milestone, and see is there any kind of adjustments that need to be made, or how are we doing?
So it sounds like that milestones might not be locked in stone, and you might be able to make some adjustments along the way, and that we can learn from either our success or failure in reaching a milestone to determine the rest of the project, and it allows us to make some adjustments.
I believe that'd be true. I mean, for myself, when I initially create the milestones for a project, it's very early on. It's typically in my charter. And so I may have an estimate, and it could be a good estimate, but still an estimate of when those dates are going to occur on milestones, right? As I go through the project, I can continue to fine-tune that and communicate that outwards.
Right. So, so like you said, a lot of times at the beginning of a project, a milestone might be your best guess, and hopefully it's based upon some knowledge and wisdom and input from others. In situations where people are paying based upon milestones, they become very important because it actually becomes income in. Here at Yale, we don't get these. You know, we're basically chartered for the whole project, so it's not like we have vendors coming in. But we do have to report, in the sense of we use a red, yellow, and green for our milestones. Can you tell us how that is used, especially up the chain to our project sponsors?
Sure. Now, let me just go back to one other thing that you were saying, though, about the payment on milestones, especially when you have a vendor involved. For me as a project manager, that's good news, because then the vendor has as much desire to hit those milestones as I do.
Right.
And so then you've got multiple people pushing towards that.
Right.
How do you use those talking with executives? For here at Yale, we typically use a RAG, red, amber, and green, mm-hmm. and we can communicate to them based on the anticipated or estimated date that we thought we would hit that, and in reality, what date did that milestone occur.
So that can actually be, to have several milestone points along the way in a project can actually be a good tool and a good methodology to communicate to senior people that you know, hey, you know, we said we were going to be here, here, and here at these dates, but reality set in and that we needed to make some adjustments. So it gives them kind of a reality check.
It does. And initially, again, going back to the charter, which is where the first time I talk about milestones is, I like to have 6 to 10, depending on the size of the project. You don't want to have too many milestones, especially in the beginning, because it's a little overwhelming. But you want to have enough that it can give people reading the charter a flavor for what those milestones are and estimated dates of when you think you're going to hit those.
Great. Well, I think that's good. So now let's talk about what isn't a milestone.
It's, again, I think in those conversations that you have with sponsors and executives, often someone will say, that is a really critical piece to this project. That needs to be a milestone. Just because something is really critical may or may not deem it as a milestone. I also liken that to if you review your critical path with your executives and they see your milestones, they will frequently confuse a milestone with something that needs to be on the critical path. They'll say, that's really critical to this project. That needs to be on the critical path. And as you know, it may or may not need to be on the critical path. To really, I think, spell something out that's critical to the project, either keep an eye on it in your scope or on a deliverable, and it may or may not be on a milestone.
So you've introduced a new term to us, and that's critical path. What's critical path mean? I caught you off guard there, but you brought it up.
So, critical path is your path from the time the project starts, and again, this is not a PMBOK definition, this is my definition.
It's all
from the
one.
Time a project starts to the time a project finishes, and how many tasks have to occur, cannot move, right, to get to that end. For example, when you start a project, you may have multiple teams working on multiple efforts.
Right.
And so you're going to want to put those potentially into a critical path model and see, okay, this particular activity has to happen at this particular time, right? And so what, and there's models and computers
right.
to do this. When you feed all of this in, it comes back and it tells you this activity, this path, nothing in it can move
right.
without affecting the back end of the project.
So for instance, I'm thinking about if I was building a house and I needed electric power by the utility company out to my site, if it was a brand new house, having electricity to my site's a critical path item. Having wood delivered is a critical path item. Having contractors there is a critical path item. But those things aren't necessarily milestones, whereas maybe getting the house, the foundation poured, or getting the framing complete, those might be milestones.
Absolutely.
Great.
Great example.
Good. Well, thank you very much once again. I think we got another good video for everybody. And
thank you.
Look forward to our next one.
Excellent. Thank you.